I'd like to demonstrate now how you can use one of these pi calculations on an actual process book display. So first I have to build one. I'll go into Tools, Datasets. I'll create a real simple one. This is a new pi calculation. It's going to be the value of the tag sinusoid plus the value of, let's try this, how about the value of CDT158 divided by 4. That'll add a small amount of randomness. Now, if you wanted to add other expressions using these functions available in performance equations, you can do that. I'm just going to keep it real simple here, though. So that's using our performance equation syntax. Now, notice, watch what happens down here when I get off of this field. This field now becomes available for us to name what this is. I'm just going to call this, how about modified sinusoid? The default value is just the word value. And because that's in fact what it is, it's the value of the calculation. But I'm going to call this modified sinusoid. That's your right. And then give this a name of a set. I'll just call this test 1. And a description is optional. Now, I get to choose the interval and the sync time. And in this case, we'll just go with, how about if we go with a 5-minute interval instead? For that, I can just change this to 5M instead of the defaults that you see that listed there. The refresh interval is going to be 1 minute. That means every minute we're going to update the screen to show us new information. And like we've said before, the step plot is typically how people would see this as a stair-step plot. Now, just by creating that, that doesn't actually make it appear anywhere. It just is a data set that I can now use. So to use this, you would bring up an object like a process book trend or a display or a bar graph, edit that trend, and then add to it, where you would normally put the tag search, you would put this pi calculation. You'll see a list of the calculations that have been saved. Now here's where it gets interesting. When I select this, you'll notice I can choose more than just the column name that I created, this modified sinusoid. You could also, if you choose, do an average using this, the calculation interval or the min or the max. As you can see, we're showing you all those results here. So that is available to you. Those are kind of the summary calculations, the standard summary calculations. I would like to see the actual calculation result. And I'll go ahead and acknowledge this. And now that becomes part of my trend. And when I click on OK here, we can see it's been displayed on the same display as ProcessBook. And when we look at the results, we can see we're just putting that calculation overlaid on the same trend as the original sinusoid. So that's how we would make use of this. Now note, you can make use of this in other objects as well. So it's not limited to just trends. I could add a value, for example, and instead of doing a traditional tag search, I'd go out and look for a pi calculation, and same as I did before. Let's put the name at the bottom, timestamp at the bottom. There we go. So here's the current value of that. So you can see it aligns to the current value we see here as well. Now that was one type of calculation. That was the expression calculation, the so-called expression calculations. Let me scroll down a little bit and let's add something new. I would like to do a new data set that simply does a series of averages. So let's say what we have is a pi tag that's just entirely too active, and we want to apply kind of a smoothing by showing an average. So let's take a look at this tag, CDT158. I'll go back one day. You should have that tag on your system. There we go. What I'd like to do is, instead of showing this in its raw form, I'd like to show a, let's say a 20-minute average going back. So in order to do that, I would need to go into Tools and then Datasets. And this time I'm going to do a calculation, except the calculation, this time is going to be a summary calculation. We're not going to put an expression here. So the name of the tag I'm going to use is CDT158. And we'll call this test2. No description necessary. If you notice, I really don't need to specify what the calculation is, because at runtime, when I'm actually designing with this data set, when I'm building the trend, that's when I get to choose the attribute I want to view. What I need to do now, though, is I need to specify that we're looking at that as a 20-minute average. So I'm going to be saying we're our calculation interval is every 20 minutes. Now I want this calculation to be done at the 0 hour mark and in 20 minutes after, and 20 minutes after that. So it'll be at 0, 20, 40, 0, 20, 40, etc. So the calculation interval takes care of the 20 minutes. This ensures that we're going to start at the top. Now the refresh interval that you see here is simply an indicator of how frequently on process book that display will update to show any new values. Now you'll see in this example, when I set this to 1 minute and then go ahead and acknowledge, we'll see a series of 20-minute calculations appear, and then once a minute we will update the most recent calculation. We'll update that most recent value. So let's go ahead and acknowledge. And what this does is it creates a brand new data set. We haven't used it yet, so to use it, I'll go into this display. Let's go ahead and make reference to the PI calculation, test 2. As you can see here, we have a choice now of just those summary calculations that I'd mentioned earlier, the average, the min, the max, etc. In this case, I wanted to do an average. As you can see, here's the sample calculation at 1 o'clock, 1240, 1220, going back at 20-minute intervals. And when I go ahead and acknowledge, I'd like to choose the average. That's what we end up identifying this as. That's the data set. That's the value average. And incidentally, it's because, as I said, it's because we're using a tag, not an expression, that you don't see that option here called value. Okay. That's what you would see if this were some kind of an expression. We were looking for that column name called value. I'll go ahead and acknowledge. And here's our end result. Yeah, this is a series of 20-minute averages shown over the course of the last 24 hours. Let me go ahead and select nothing here, and I'll set this. Let's go instead of 1 day, let's just go to 4 hours. You can see the, you know, here are the 20-minute calculations. The only thing we really haven't demonstrated yet is what it would look like if you were to turn off that stepped plot. Remember, you would do this from within the data set definition. So I can go in here and say, let's turn that off. We're warned that that's going to affect this trend. That's no problem. Now you can see what this looks like with that, without the stepped plot. Take a look at this at 4 hours. Yeah, there we go. So now the average here in blue is no longer a stepped plot. So as I explained, this is going to update automatically. Let me go ahead and revert this back. This is updating, in our case, we're updating once a minute. It's looking out, seeing if it can do another 20-minute calculation. So this is going to update as we look forward in time or move forward in time. And also, at some point, you may find it very useful to have kind of a list of those things that are currently affected by this data set. So I'll go into data sets. One of the options is to choose this show use, and it shows you what's currently making use of that data set. Now the data sets, they are stored with the process book displays. So you'll notice if I save this display and then close it, that saving this display and then closing it is going to eliminate this list of data sets. So here are my data sets. I'll go ahead and close my display. As you can see, let's open up a brand new display here. As you can see now, if I go into Tools, Data Sets, we no longer see those two that we had just created. Those are created and available through that display that I created here. Tools, Data Sets. Okay, now let's say at some point you really do need to copy these data sets from one display to another. No problem. Just create the new display or make sure that new display is open. Here's a display. I'll just call this my target display for convenience here. This is going to be the target of where we're copying our data sets to. If you look at Tools data sets, again, even though the other display is open, we don't see those data sets. We only see them when we have that display in context. So if I go into Tools data sets, now that I have those, I'll go ahead and select this one right here. I'll copy that, and I'm going to copy it over to this one that I just created. Having copied that now, and only now, this is now available for me. If I go into Tools Data Sets, there it is, Test 2. Even if I close this, it's there. You're going to have to save this, make sure that's saved, so you've got your data set stored with this display. And of course, now if I do want to trend this data set, I'll just go ahead and do it the way I did with the other one. I'll just go in, select that as a data set, select what I want to look at, etc., etc. So that's now available to this new display.